World Bank Country Director for the Maldives, Nepal and Sri Lanka, Faris Haddad Zervos, concluded a successful visit to Sri Lanka yesterday, where he reiterated the World Bank's commitment to support Sri Lanka's efforts towards recovery and to build back better from the COVID-19 pandemic.
The visit of the World Bank management also saw the signing of two important agreements between the World Bank and the Sri Lankan government. A $69.53 million credit will help improve dams and irrigation schemes covering 165,000 hectares of agricultural land and improve the management of watersheds and water resources, benefiting 356,000 farming families. Under a second $69.33 million loan, a modern transport terminal will be built in a Kandy city that will integrate rail, bus, three-wheeler and pedestrian traffic to make it safer and more efficient. The current World Bank portfolio in Sri Lanka consists of 19 ongoing projects with a total commitment value of $2.33 billion in a variety of sectors, including transport, urban, agriculture, water, education and health. Today, the World Bank Country Director participated in a webinar organized by the Pathfinder Foundation Sri Lanka. Former Governor of the Central Bank of Sri Lanka, Dr. Indrajit Kumaraswamy, also participated in it.
Yesterday, there was an agreement by the World Bank senior management to also make available $81 million for Sri Lanka to help with vaccine acquisition along with other supplies. And we're expecting our forecast for 2021 is 3.4% and for 2022 is 2.0%. How those were done, I could tell you, and I'm sure you know this, they're very complex formulas which take a huge number of assumptions. We have actually been discussing with the central bank and with others our assumptions versus theirs. We had a meeting with the central bank and the Honorable Governor of the central bank, and we were going through these things. So there's a lot of areas where we had different assumptions. At our assumptions, we have different assumptions than our colleagues at the IMF. And I think that happens. So I think what's really important is to look at the direction. So I think, that's one of the issues. We need to look at what the trajectory is. And we look at the vulnerabilities. What are the things that are going to impact the GDP?
One of the lessons that the East and Southeast Asians learned from the Asian financial crisis, the importance of having buffers in your economy. They built up insurance through running large external reserves. They created fiscal space. In our case, we tend to live on the edge. So when there is a crisis, it's very difficult to respond because there is a challenge in terms of fiscal space, there's a challenge in terms of external reserve, and then sometimes we are forced to settle for a much lower equilibrium than need be if we had some space. So I think going forward, when we're going to build back better, we identified certain preferences. But for Sri Lanka specifically, one needs to add another one, which is that we should work at building buffers.